Good morning, students. In this lecture, we will discuss about the code tree and Rayleigh's diagram of convolution encoding process. Before starting this lecture, we will slightly discuss about the basic of our convolution coding. So first of all, we will say about the encoding methods. So we have generally three types of encoding methods: code tree, state transition diagram, and Rayleigh's diagram. So before starting this, we have to already see what about the state transition diagram, and by using the state transition diagram, how we can encode our data signals. So first of all, we will slightly revise our previous lecture. What about the convolution encoder and how it will convert your input data bits into the encoding? So basically, we have seen that in convolution encoder, there is also a memory part. And here we are using the, we design our encoder by using the shift registers. And shift register is basically made up of our flip-flop. So that is basically a memory elements also included in this type of convolution encoder. So you have to see that if you have to given the input data bits, so what will happen here? So there are certain features. You have a two outputs U1 and U2, and that is basically a combination of these three bits, what three bit shift registers. So you can take the different combinations of these three bits at a time for their addition purpose. So where the first one takes the incoming bit and rest all the memory of the encoder. So initially we are starting from, so we can say that at a time we are taking the three bits at a time for our outputs. Our input bit will be entered one by one. So at a time, one bit can be entered, and in next clockwise, our second bit will be entered. So this is basically a sequential of one bit one shift register. So this is basically a serial input data, and you can take the output at a time from you. So that is the parallel output data in our shift registers. So here you can see that U1 and U2. So U1 is the addition of all three bits of shift registers, and here U2 is the addition of first and last bit of this shift register. So this is a basically a convolution encoder. By using that, we can convert upon our message data or message bit into the output, coded output. So how we can done the coding? This is the process by which we can convert our, what type of inputs you have to given, you can convert that input into the coded outputs. And again, we are talking about the key, what is the basic, you can see here, just there is a, suppose you have to given the message signals M that is equal to 101. So as you can see here, you can start first bit, after then second bit, and after then you can enter the third bit. So according to that, you are receiving, so when you are enter the first bit, you can receive your output 1 1. So that is a basically group of U1 and U2. Again, you will enter the second bit. So first bit will be shifted to the next place. And again, we are get the output U1, U2, that is the 1 0. So again, third bit. And after crossing these all bits, we have to also add some dummy bits so that our first bit will be reach out to the last bit. So that is the basic process by using that. So we have add here dummy bits in there. So we can also add 0 and 0. So in this way, your all bits will be exit to the, and this is the basic your encoded outputs 1 1 1 0 0 0 1 0 1 1. So you can see here. So this is the our basic encoding methods, and by using these encoding methods, we will see here now how we can plot our code tree. So now we will move towards the designing of our code tree. So that is basically a representation of our output of our encoders. So first of all, if you are talking about the encoding process, so that will be the same. You can see here there are three bits, and you are working on the combination of these two bits. So now what will happen here, you can see, if you are talking about the output, so you have a two output, so that is the combination of these three, and either you can take the first and last bit combination of. So same thing, that is what we have taken U1 and U2. So now here you have to represent, you can calculate your message bit into the convolution encoded outputs. So this you have seen that how you can plot your code tree and what is the basic process of representation of your convolution output in the form of code tree. So that is the another method by using that we can represent our output data of our coded data. So in previous lectures we have seen that we have also seen the state transition diagram, and by using these encoder method we have plot our message signals into the state transition diagram. So here now we will see that how we can make a code tree by using this method. So just you can see there is a two options. If you are talking about the what type of inputs are entering in your encoder, so there is two options. That bit will be either 0 or 1. So before starting our code tree, that is the basic initial point where we will start. So there is again a two options. Either your first bit will be 0 or your first bit will be 1. So before starting this, we have to assume that initially all flip-flops are 0, means your shift register is reset and all the bits are at the 0, 0, 0. And after then, when your first bit will be entered, so there is a probability of 2. Either that bit will be 1 or that bit will be 0. So according to that, when your first bit will enter, there is two options. So either you can move upward or you can move the downward. So that is fixed. If your bit is 0, so you have to move the upward, and when your first bit will be 1, so you have to move the downward. So for suppose your first bit 0 and that one is a 1. So now what will happen here? There are so many options, and according to that you can define your state. So if you are A, initially you are A and your first bit will be 0. So what will happen here? You will decide your state. So how you can decide? If we have to also seen our previous lectures, if there is 0, 0, so you can treat it as a state. 0, 1, we will read out it as a B, C, and D. So what type of bit you are entering? So remaining two bits, if there are three bits, so remaining two bits will decide the position or state of our flip-flop. So if initial level, since all bits are 0, 0, 0, so your first bit will be either 0 or 1, your state will be initially, since 0, so you will shift your 0 to the second position, then your state will be defined. So when we will decide our state, we will enter our bit first position, then we will calculate the output of our encoders, and what will be the next state, it will be decided when our first bit will be shifted to their second positions and new bit will be ready to enter. So when you are shifted to the second position, and what about the conditions of that particular value, suppose that is the M2 and M3, so that according to that you can decide your the state. So that state will be the A state, because all are 0 and you are again shifted to the 0. In other parts, if you are talking about the 1, so if you are entering the 1, now what will happen here? Suppose your first bit will be 1. So you have to move this path. Your first bit will be 1. So what will happen here? You will enter your 1 bit here. And now remaining 2 bits are 0, 0. So what will be the addition? Addition will be 1, 1. So your output will be 1, 1. But now what will happen here? What will be the state? So when you have decided your state, you will shift your 1 into the second place of that particular encoder. And that particular encoder will read out as a 0, 1. So that will be the state. So how you can decide your state? So when you are shifting your 1, so that will be the state of 0 and 1, and your state will be B. So that is basically your state will be decided by the basically M2 minus 1 and L minus 1. So in this way, if you are entering bit here, so this will decide our state. So that is the input data, and in this diagram we are working on here. So your input bit is entering here, and last two bits are responsible for the decision, taking the state level decision. So when your bit will you move here 1, so that is the 0 1, and that state will be the B state. So that is a process either you can take here. So that is the basic place your input is entering in this place, and this 2 bits will decide you the state positions. So that is a basic theme. One by one, if first bit will be 0, so there is again a 2 condition. What about the second bit? So there is again 2 options. Your second bit will be either 0 or 1. So in this code tree, you have again a 2 options. Either you can move upward when your second bit will be 0, or if your second bit will be 1, so you have to move the downward. So your output will be again 0 0 1 1, and you will decide B state and A state, as we have to already see. Now what about the third bit? So if third bit, there is again a 2 options. Okay, so that third bit, so if your second bit will be 0, so your third bit will be either 0 or 1. So there is again a 2 options, and you have to further move to the final bits will be crossed to the that particular point. And again, you have to given it. If second bit will be 1, so there is again an option that third bit will be either 1 or 0. So according to that, you will plot your graph. So this is the way. This is the code tree. According to that, we can insert your bit. And you have 2 options. If you have a 0, so you have to move upward. And if you have a 1, so you have to move the downward path. So this is the conclude path. In this way, you can represent your output, encoded output in this code tree format. So now we will see here how you can plot these. So we will take one examples for this. Suppose this one, we can take it. Suppose you have to given the 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So this is the input data. And now you have to plot. So there is a 2 options. Either you can plot it in a code tree format, or you can also plot it in a state transition diagram. So if we are talking about the state transition diagram, so in that particular way, we have a 4 state: state A, state B, state C, and state D. So according to that, what type of inputs we are achieving, we can plot that particular output. So both diagrams we will compare here. Suppose you have a given 0, 1, 0, 1, 0. So your first bit will be 0. So now what will happen in code tree? If your first bit will be 0, so you have decided, this is fixed, that you have to move the upward, because your first bit will be 0. And when you enter the 0, what about the output? Your output are 0, 0. So you can give your output. So this path will indicate the output. So this is the output part. Now what about the second bit? Your second bit will be 1. So now what will happen? You have to move the downward. This is fixed, because if you have a 0, you have to move upward. And if you have a second bit will be 1. So there is again a 2 options. Either you can move upward or you can move downward. But this time, in previous diagram, we are taking the options. There is 2 options. So first bit. But here we have to given the message data. So according to that message data, we will move either upward or downward. So it will depend on the what will be the your next bit. So according to that, your next bit will be 1. So you can see here 1. Your output will be 1 1. When you insert your 1 and take the output, so that is encoder part is fixed. What type of encoder we are designing at that particular. So that is the 1 1, and again you have a options about the third bit. So now what will happen here? What about the third bit? So third bit will be 0. So again you will move the upward. And when you enter your third bit, you have again take the output, and output will be 1 0. Now your fourth bit, so that is equal to 1. So you have to move the downward. So this is the path. If you have given the message, you have not completed all the branches of this code tree. Because if you are talking about the, if you have a message bits number is k, so you have a 2 raised to power k branches in that particular code tree. So what we have to done, so we have 5, so we have a 32 branches, because we have a 5 bits, so 2 to the power 5, that is equal to 32 branches in this way. So you have to move upward, downward, upward, downward. So but if you have given the any data, so in the lower half branch is rejected, because your first bit is 0, so you have to move the upper part. and if you have to one, so you have to go through the negative parts. So you can see in our here we have covered the both the branches. So that will be depend on the how many number of bits you have, and according to that you have that particular branches in that particular code tree. So that is basically a representation of our encoded output. So you have a given a simple encoder. So first of all, if you want to try to calculate the output, so output will be calculated only with the help of encoder, and after that we will represent our coded output in terms of either code tree, or you can represent in terms of state transition diagram, or you can represent it in terms of the trellis diagram. So this is the three encoding methods which we have to use in our convolution coding part. So now we will see here. This is a very simple, and now you can also make a transition diagram. So because you have a option, you can decide when you have to enter zero, we will again slightly revise this graph. When you enter zero, you have an option. You have to move upward. It is fixed. When you move upward, for this particular message bit, we will design the state transition. So when you move upward, means first bit is zero, and after shifting the zero, what will be the state? Your state will be A. So you can see here, initially you are A, and again your next state will be A. So this is the same circle from when we are moving A to A. So you can represent it as a circle. So this is the path you are presently here. When your next bit will be 1, so you have to move to the downward, and your output will be 1 1. So what will happen, when your next bit will be 1, so when you shifted 0 here and your next bit will be 1, so what about the your output? Our output will be 1 1. And when your what is the your state, how you can decide your state? After shifting 1. So when your second bit will be shifted to that particular second position, then you will decide your state. So now when 1 is shifted to that second place, second position of that particular shift registers, so your state will be 0 1. And how you can indicate your state 0 1? We will indicate 0 1 by using the so that is basically state B 1 0. So that is the path from A. So this is indicate from A you are going to the B, and B is the state B that is indicated as 1 0. So that is basically that is a slightly given to you. So that is the 1 1. After then it's the third bit, so you can again calculate the output, and from which state B to C you are moving, B to D or B to C. You have two paths. So according to our state, so after shifting we have to calculate our state, and then we will define that particular part. So that is the basically when you are working on the encoder. And so there are two options. You have to calculate the output voltage, and after calculating the output voltage, output bits, you have to shift your data into the next positions. And now after shifting the next position, you will decide your state, and then you can decide in which state your particular output signal have to go. So suppose A to A, so you can make it as a circle. Suppose your output is a 1 1 and your next state will be B. So here you will move from A to B. So that is the basic part. You have to move from A to B part. Now in again, you can also move from A to D, A to C, if there is any shifting. So that is depend. What about your previous bit? What about your next bit? So according to, so you have to shift your message bit 1 by 1. So after entering the data, you have to first calculate the output, and after shifting your data one place, then you will decide your the next state. So this is the process. By using that, we can define our what should be our next state. So this is a code tree, and this is the state transition diagrams. And by using these two diagrams, we can represent our encoded output. So little bit we will move forward. So this is again a tree diagram. You have given the any input data 101, and you can plot it. But there is again a little bit changes. So what about the changes? You have receiving here the 3-bit output. So just you can see in previous slides we have seen the output of 2 bits. So just you can see this type of encoder, what type of encoder you have to design. So here
your shift register is 3 bit, but what will happen here, your output will be the 3 outputs. We are taking the 3 outputs, mean there are different combinations of these 3 bits. So you can take here 1, 2 and 3. So there are 3 outputs, and by using these outputs you can calculate. So if there are 3 outputs, so their output bits are combination of, so output bits group of combination of 3 bits. So you can receive your data in group of 333. So your convolution encoder is coded your output in bits of 3, and that is depend how you can design your encoders. And what about the modulo 2 adder operations are given to you? So according to that, we will describe the code rate according to our output, number of outputs. So that is basically key at a time, how many number of bits you are entering. So that is a standard value of k, that is equal to 1. And n is equal to 3, so that decides how many number of outputs or in how many groups. So in a particular group of your output, how many bits are included. So it will be 2, it will be 3 according to our design, designing of encoder bit. So here again, this is an example of taking the 3-bit groups in our coded output. So that is basically, since our that is the part, so you can decide your states 00, 01, 10 and 11. So this is a basically conditions which we will apply here. So one by one, when there is a 1 or 0 according to first bit, you can move. Since your first bit is 1, so you can move the downward. Second bit is 0, move upward as we have to seen. And what about the output? So output is the basically what type of 1, 2, 3 output is designed. So that is based on the combination of our output. So according to that, you will calculate your output. So second bit is 0, you will move upward. And what about the third bit? Third bit will again 0, third bit is again 1, so you will move to the downward. And this is our basic code tree graph of this particular message signals. So you can see here, for a further movement, if you want to shift your third bit to the last position, you will add 2 dummy zeros for moving that particular part to the further states. So I think this type of code tree is clear to you. You have to design it. So there is a simple encoder. By using the encoder, you will calculate your coded output, and then your coded output and what is that next state. So by using that particular two data, we can plot our the code tree. Little bit, we will again take the second examples. So in this example, the number of outputs are 3 and input bits are 1010. So here we are moving our. So we will apply for same process we will apply for here. So now we will switch little bit to the Trellis diagram. So what about the Trellis diagram? And Trellis diagram is third method of encoding method of our convolution. So in third method of convolution, what will happen here? So that is basically a enhanced version of our state transition diagram. So we will see in this graph that what about our state transition diagram. So generally we have a 4 state, state A, state B, state C and state D. So that is called as a 00, 01, 10 and 11. So these are our 4 states. And by using these 4 states, we can also plot our coded output in terms of state transition state. Now we will little move to the enhanced version of that particular state transition diagram, and that is based on the Trellis diagram. So that is after using this state transition diagram, so how we can modify these state transition diagram into the Trellis diagram. So here you have to given the input bit 101 and that you have to coded your output in a group of 3 bits because your encoder is 3 bit encoder. So now you can see here how you can modify. You are just plotting your graph into this form. You can see here this is your state transition diagram. So what do you have? A to B, A to C shifting. So there is A, C, B, so E. So you can also plot in these points. Means you can shift your these four state which are distributed in 360 degree. Now you have to distribute these A, B, C, D into a straight line. So you can represent. So first stage is, first of all, you have to represent your all state transition diagram into a straight line. Okay. So just you can see, you will move A to C. So there is a C, B, and D. So you have take what a type of A, B, C, D. So char state are given here. So D is a little bit, we have to take D, and here is the E. So there is nothing. So how you can take in a straight line? So before starting, what you have to see, if you are to moving towards the one state, suppose we are in a state A. So there is two options. Either you will be in a state A if first bit is zero, or if your first bit is one, so you can move either B or C state. So you have option, and you have to move forward for using that particular values. So you can see here, you have so many options. You can move B to C, C to B. So there are many options here, and you have to generate, or you have to prepare a basic chart. So just I can show you the diagram, then I will explain you, and it will be better. So if your trellis diagram is basically extension of that is, and all possible states are shown for each instant of time. So each instant of time is, if we are at the zero or initial state, so we have four states: A0, B0, C0, D0. If you are in the second clock pulse existing, so we have a A1, B1, C1, D1. If third clock pulse, so A2, B2, C2, so we have all state for each instant of time, and time is indicated by a moment of to the right. So you have to always move to the right side, not to the back path. So you have always options. You have so many points in this trellis diagram, and you have to remember that you have to always move to the right side. The input data bits and output code bits are represented by a unique path. So that is basically, we have to follow a unique path, that is the trellis. The lines are labeled with C, and C is the output. So what about the, so we have to see how we will see that particular path. And each node in the trellis has 2^k incoming path and 2^k outgoing path. So we have so many paths in this way. So we can see here, solid line indicates the input bit is 0, and dotted line represent that. So we will see in this diagram. Just you can see that is the dotted. Now suppose what we have to see, at each instant you have many options. So you can see here, initial state is A. You can define it as A0. You have the many states of A. This, and this. These are the all states of A. These are the all state of B. And these are the all state of C. And these are the all state of D. So you can also define it as a initial state. So you can write it as a A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, and A5. So that is I bracket 1, 2, 3, 4. So that is indicated as a. Again, B0. That is a B0, B1, B3. B3, B4, B5. So that is basically 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. C1, C2, C3, C4, C5. So that is a basically a base structure in which you have to make a release diagram by using the encoded output. So first of all, your basic encoder will be same. What you have to using in last. So if you are there is a 3-bit output, so you can represent it a 3-bit combination. So either you can represent it as a 3-bit combination, or you can your output will be 2-bit. So there is nothing, process will be same. Your output will be depend on the what type of encoder bit you have to design for that particular combinations. So you can see here, before starting this, we will just clear to you, if your first bit will be 1, or 0. So it will, if you A is at the initial state, and if your first bit will be 1, so you can see here 1, you will move here. If your first bit will be 0, so you will move this way. And if first bit will be 1, and it will be shifted to the next place, what will be the state? So that state will be C. So next state will be C. So your output will be 1, 1, 1, and your state will be C. Now, what about the second bit? If second bit is 0, so you have to again decide. You have again here two options. Either you can move 0 or 1. 0 and 1. You have always options. If your second bit is, what is your second bit? It depends on what about the output and next state. So your state will be B. So after, when you are moving A0, so A from A0, you have to move the 1. And after, one state, so that is a 1, I is equal to 1, so then you can again move to the 2 state, not you will move to the this side. So you have to move always to the right direction. So you have move upward. If you are at present 1 state and at that particular I is equal to 1, you have to decide what will be the next transition state. So that will be the I2, I3, I4, not to the left side. You have to always move to the right side. So this is a basic diagram of our release diagram. You can see here. So your path will be moved this way. Again, here is the second bit will be entered. So now what will happen when your second bit will be entered? You have to calculate the coded output. And now after shifting that bit, you will decide your state. So that state will be C. So now you will move to the C2, you will move to the C3, because at present you are in I is equal to 2, state 2. So now you have to move to the C3. You have to go to the C, but there is many options of C. C3 is also, C2 is also nearby, and C1 is also. So you have to move the C3 because you have to move the upward always when you are making the release diagram, because you have many options: A0, A1, A2, A3, A4, A5, B1, B2, B3, B4, B5, B6, C1, C2, C3, and D1, D2. So after point, you have the option of C. C options have to occur in many times. So you have to decide when you are at the I is equal to T. So next state will be I is equal to 3, and whatever the value of A, B, C, D. When you are at presently I is equal to 3, so your next state or your transition state will be moved to the I4. So whatever value of A4, B4, C4, D4. So that is a basically forwarding movement of our path. So I think it will be a little bit clear to you. We will again take one example of this release diagram. You can make, so first of all, you have to basically draw. If you are talking about the k is equal to, we are taking the always one. So we will use this, what will happen here? And these, after these encoder method, you have to again decode your signal at the receiver part. So this is again a task, how you can reconvert your task in trellis diagram or code tree. So that is a different way which we have to study in our next lecture. So here, what about the, thus just a summary of our encoders. So we have an encoding method, we have an encoder, and we have done the convolution coding. So why we are doing the convolution coding? For removing the error, because so many errors are introduced in our channel, in our message signal during the transmission in channel. So we have to opt the, at transmitter section, before transmitting our signals, we have introduced some redundant bits for find out the errors in that particular message bits. So for that, we have three options again: state transition diagram, code tree, and release diagram. So we have to see that how. So all these three encoders are based on the basic working principles of our encoder. How your bit will enter one by one, and how you will achieve your output voltage. So this is the theme. In every diagrams or every representation of your encoded outputs, we have to use the encoders. And that is the 2-bit combinations of output voltage or 3-bit combinations. It is based on your designing and how many number of bits you are want to working in this. basically encoder part. Now if you are working, so before starting encoder, you can make either tree, code tree, as we have to seen in our previous slides. Either you can make a transition diagram, we will also see in our previous slides. Now what about our task? Our task is that now we have to convert our state transition diagram into the trellis diagram. So for converting the trellis diagram, there is so many options in our trellis diagram, and it is more clear. Because if you are talking about the A state, so we have to see that in a state transition diagram, all things are moving here and there. It's some loops here forward, again revert back, again. So there are so many loops in a state transition diagram. So for there is so much confusion. So apart from that, we have to spread it that state transition diagram in terms of trellis diagram. And now every state have a multiple options, and they will properly define by using the trellis diagram. So if we have a option A, so if you are at the state initial first 0 or 1, 2, 3, 4, and according to that we have so many options, A0, A1. So that is basically A is also many options, B has also many options, C has also many options, and D has also many options. So this is the spreaded part, and by using the first bit is either 0, either 1, either 0, either 1, according to that we will move. So here, here is not a fixed path, either you have to move upward or downward. Only thing is, what about bit you have to enter, you have to calculate the output bit, and what, and after then you have to decide the state, and what state this output have to follow. So according to that state, we will move our coded output to that particular state. And if you are at the state, if you have done the I is equal to 1 and you are working on I is equal to 1, state is I first bit enter, and now when second bit enters, so where it have to go, it will decide it to the right hand side movement of that particular. You not move to the left hand side, either it will be bit is left not occupied, so doesn't matter, but you have to always move. If you are at the I is equal to 1, so you have to take the state, either you have to take the state B or C, so you have to move either B2 or C2. You have many options, either B2 or C2, you can opt it. So that is the basic forward movement of our signals to this path. So by using that, we can map our input data in trellis format. And these encoded trellis format is also very useful for decoding our signals at the receiver part. So in this lecture, we will not start our decoding part. We will only discuss about the encoders. So I think it will be clear to you what about the trellis and relationship between. So you can see a little bit revisions how you can convert our these state transition diagram. You can also see in this diagram there are so many loops. This is a many loops are so these are not actually clear how we are how many bits. So in this diagram we can't told it in which state or third bit, what is the output of third bit, fourth bit, because all loops are moving from A, B, C, D between this here and there. So by proper explanation of this, what is the basic initial state of your signal, so we can convert these signals into the you can see trellis diagram. So you can see here, if you are moving on this one, so you can know that is a third bit output, and it is what about the state of that. If you are on this place, so you can define that what about the fourth bit entry of this particular point, what about the fifth bit entry of this particular point. So in if you are working on the trellis diagram, so it will be very clear to you in which particular state you are presently in the coded output. So you can you have to done the practice of making this diagram, because it is not very tough, but this is a very conceptual case concept. You have to know how you have to. So first of all, you have an encoder, you have to enter bit one by one, and then you have to calculate the output, and in front of your calculated output you have to write down the state in which that particular output have to go. So this is fixed, you have to enter a bit, calculate the output, and then you have to decide in which particular transition state it will be existing. So I think it will be clear to you, you have know the three or four things only when we have to plot anything. First of all, what type of encoders you are using, 2-bit outputs or 3-bit outputs. Second one is you have to enter your input data serially one by one, and by entering the data you have to calculate the output, and by shifting the data to the next position you have to calculate the state in which your output have to go. So this is the summary sections ki how you can design. So if you are comfortable with working of your encoder, then you can plot either transition diagram, you can plot either trellis diagram, or you can plot either code tree diagram. So there is nothing, everything in every diagrams you have a output part and you have a state in which your output have to go. So all these things you have to remember in this way. Now we will little bit switch to the objective questions which we have to insert here by working on this diagram. You can solve your objective questions. So I think if you have to clear all the encoder process which we have to. So we have to work out on the basic part of that. So I think you have to aware about an error correction. So which of the following is not error correction and detection code? So I think we have to cover so many codes: block code, cyclic code, convolution code. So you are more comfortable with decide which type of coding process we have to follow. And if you are opting about the decoding method, so you can very comfortable by using the decoding the four states of encoder on vertical axis of trellis diagram. What does the solid line indicate? So that is basically in which states you are working. So for the four states of encoder vertical axis of trellis diagram, so you have to first of all make a trellis diagram. It is a very important thing. There is in every point you have a options of plotting your state. And you have to go through the decoding part. That is again a questions. Okay, how, what is the maximum likelihood conditions trellis diagram? You can see here horizontal axis, vertical axis. What is the notation of these horizontal and vertical axis notations? So there is again, by using these trellis diagram we will work out on the Viterbi algorithm, and by using that trellis diagram we can work out decoding. So if we are talking about the decoding, so what will happens here when your message bit is 5 bits and then you are entering one by one to your encoder, you will receive the output in terms of group of bits. And in receiver part, now you have to again these decoded messages or these encoded output you have to given, and then you have to decide in which bit these outputs are coming. So you have to decide the input bits of that particular part. So I think you have to clear for how the convolution encoding will be done by using these three types of methods: code tree, transition tree, and trellis tree. So trellis tree is basically very important method in present scenario. Mostly we are working on the trellis diagram, and it is very comfortable. In every particular point you have know about the in which is particular bits, in which particular bits you are working, either second bit, either third bit, or the fourth bit, because there is particular state is defined and we have to move to the further towards the what type of states we have to designing. So trellis diagram is very important in our present scenario. So okay, thank you. Today we have completed our encoder sections, and in our next lecture we will cover the decoding of that particular. So according to that, decoding is also based on the either code tree decoding or the trellis diagram decoding. What type of code encoding message you have to done, so that is a reverse process we have to apply at the receiver sections. Okay, thank you.